हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज करते सागर। आई वेलकम यू ऑल। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस समथिंग अबाउट इंडस्ट्रियल रिवॉल्यूशन। ओके, इंडस्ट्रियल रिवॉल्यूशन। राइट नाउ वी आर इन अ इरा वेयर द टॉपिक इंडस्ट्रियल रिवॉल्यूशन 4 इज समथिंग दैट इज पॉपिंग आउट। ओके, दिस इज समथिंग विच इज करंटली इन द मार्केट दैट एवरीवन इज सेइंग दैट वी आर एट द फेज दैट इंडस्ट्रियल रिवॉल्यूशन 4 इज बिगेनिंग। So that is why I am trying to let us understand what is industrial revolution and how that phases of industrial revolution that affect the current that market of the timeline, the political and geographical content of that time. Okay, so timeline that affect many a time and that affect the people and society. So let's understand what is industrial revolution first of all, and then step by step I will try to make sure that you understand that how that industrial revolution affect the humanity and the humans and society. Okay, so first of all let us start. So let's try to understand what is industrial revolution. First of all, industrial revolution is something that before industrial revolution that hand techniques were used for manufacturing anything. Hand techniques were used, so every machines were not there and machine tools were there. Okay, machine tool were there, tools was used and hands are used for producing or fabricating anything. So that was the era before industrial revolution. We are talking about first industrial revolution around 18th century, or you can say 1750, around 1750 to 1850. That was the time that first industrial revolution was there. Okay, and on that time, before that, the hand production methods were used. Okay, so there is a lacking in the production, you can say that on that time that due to hand production method there is a need of more humans for working. So human resource was scarce, you can say there is a scarcity of human resource on that time, and due to that there is a need of machines for production. Okay, my market demand was high, and compensating to the market we have to introduce machines. So you can say that machines was found very early in the early age of first century, second century there was machines. Okay, machines and the mechanical energy was given to them. Okay, and human was used as a energy to run that machine. So machines was invented very much more before the this first industrial revolution there. Okay, but to reach the demand of market and to compensate for the lack of human resource, machines was introduced in the industries. Okay, and first industries was established in the England. You can say the UK was the time where there is a cotton industries, and cotton industry was run on a hand production methods. So human were working on the machine. Using hand tool they are producing running the cotton industries. So there is a need of machine. So firstly machines was introduced in the cotton industries in UK, and you can say that first industrial revolution began. Okay, and now after that, that was a period of you can say like a century, 100 years. So there is so many things that is industrialized. Okay, on before that, that you can say small scale factories, you can say very small scale industries was running, and they are producing all the different products which are demanded by the market. Okay, then second thing is new chemical manufacturing process was introduced for creating, or you can say manufacture chemicals. Obviously you can say that there is right now, if you see the market, there is so many things which are you can say products are manufactured by the chemicals. So they are chemical manufacturing. Okay, you can say that chemical manufacturing is something like you have to produce chemical by some chemical reactions. But for a larger amount, that is to supply the into a market, you have to do the chemical manufacturing. For example, if you see that ammonia is used as a fertilizer in the agriculture sector, so you have there is high demand of you can say fertilizer in the agriculture sector, so you have to go for the chemical manufacturing. Okay, not every farmer is going for producing that chemical or fertilizer at his home, so he is going for buying somewhere in the market, so you have to go for the chemical manufacturing. I am just giving one example. Okay, you can say that chemical you are using your daily products, like you can say that soaps is using, you are using shampoos, all are the chemicals. Okay, and if you see all around your household things, all are mostly are chemicals. Okay, so we are producing we are using chemicals, so you have to go for chemical manufacturing for high demand of market. Then iron production process was introduced. You can say that iron ore from the ground, so we have extracting the iron from the land below and we are using it for our goods. Okay, you can say that iron products are so many around us, so many iron products are there, and you can see physically. Okay, you can see that automobile vehicles are there. Okay, you can see that buildings are using the steels and all that. So iron products, that was the time where the iron production was in before there iron was there. Okay, but the production process was not there. On small scale they are producing iron, but as a industry there was nothing like iron production processes. So they are introduced in the industrialized the iron production. Okay, because there was a high demand of iron need of iron in the market, so there is a need of industrialization. So basically we are working on a demand on that time. Okay, we are talking about that in the early 18th century there was a demand, high demand, and we need to industrialize things to run the business and market smoothly. Okay, next is that increasing use of steam power. Okay, steam, you know that if you boil a water that will convert into a steam, and early beginning of the you can say this steam power, you can say that water power and steam power, you can see water power and steam power. Okay, we know that with the use of water we can rotate a turbine. So we have an idea on before that we have an idea that we can utilize the water as an energy, or we can convert the water into steam, and we can use that water as steam as a power. So we have idea, obviously we have idea, but we don't have that vision that we can utilize it for industrialization. Okay, so I will explain it to you that how it went, how we used steam power and water power in the industries. Okay, so that was that you can say that instead of human as energy we were using a horse or some kind of animal or a human for giving the motion input as an input energy, we are using those. Okay, so we have an idea that we can use it, utilize the steam or water. So that was something that is revolutionary. The next day, the development of machine tools. Okay, machine tools was there, so we have utilized that machine tool and we have mechanized the factory system. Okay, before that there was no factory system, so we have introduced machine tools and we have made some mechanisms to create mechanize those things. So we have proved some mechanisms and given some input energy as a, you can see steam and power or water power. And when we mechanized the factory system, which was very revolutionary, so you can say it is over 100 years there was so many things that is formed. Okay, then that was something that is revolutionary. Now let us understand how it went. Okay, first of all you can see over here that is this power, steam power engines. Okay, in the early 18th century. Okay, they have idea that steam power can be utilized for running something. Okay, you can utilize as a power as an input and you can get some output as a work. So in this case we are what we are doing, we are giving power तो द पिस्टन एंड पिस्टन इज मूविंग प्रोवाइडिंग दैट एनर्जी एंड ट्रांसफॉर्म दैट एनर्जी इन टू रोटेटिंग एनर्जी एंड दैट रोटेटिंग एनर्जी इज यूजफुल एंड वी हैव यूज दैट रोटेटिंग एनर्जी टू प्रोपेल दिस इंजिन. ओके सो दिस इज लोकोमोटिव इंजिन यू कैन सी. ओके रेल रेल इंजिन यू कैन से दैट कॉटन इंडस्ट्रीज इन यू के. ओके बेसिकली यू कैन सी ओवर हियर दिस इज अ पुली ओवर हियर एंड देर इज़ वन शाफ्ट दैट इज फॉर ट्रांसमिटिंग द एनर्जी. सो ऑन वन शाफ्ट देर इज सो मेनी पुलीज दैट आर माउंटेड एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ स्टीम वी हैव कन्वर्टेड दैट एनर्जी इन टू द रोटेटिंग मोशन एंड दैट रोटेटिंग मोशन इज ट्रांसमिटेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ बेल्ट टू द मशीन. सो दिस मशीन वॉज ऑपरेटेड मैन्युअली बिफोर दैट बट आफ्टर इंडस्ट्रियल रिवोल्यूशन there is something that happened that steam power was used and that this machines was operated by the steam. So that need of that human for rotating was obviously we have discussed that there is a lack of human resource for working. So they have worked on machines and that revolutionized that we come to know that first this industry which is powered by the steam. Okay, so as an energy we have used steam. So this is the early beginning of 18th century where we can see that steam was used as a power, okay, and to run a industry. So this you can see this is a something called steam as a motive force. We have used steam as a motive force. You are entering steam is entering over here and that is pushing this piston over here which is having a reciprocating motion and that energy is with the help of some mechanism we are transmitting and transforming both the thing. In first phase we are transmitting the motion to this cross rail and after that that is with the help of this connecting rod that is transferred to the these are wheels, okay, or crank. So that is transforming energy. So we are transmitting and transforming energy with the help of this mechanism which is called we can call it a single slider crank mechanism, you can call it something like that. Okay, so this was the steam as a motive force and this end product of this energy was used to propel a you can say engine, okay, you can say a vehicle. So it was used, okay. Second, we have used this, we have connected it with the help of shaft and moved to the factories. So factory was run by the steam which is also a revolution on that time, okay, very interesting thing on the early beginning of 18th century. Okay, so you can say that first of all this commercially successful engine was invented by Thomas New Coleman. Okay, Thomas New Coleman, he introduced this thing first commercially, he is used and he is used steam as a continuous power, used for continuous power to the machines. And after that James Watt made some critical improvement in the design. Okay, in the what was the change in the design, that whatever the steam we are using here as a input, and after that it will condense, it will cool down little bit, and that will steam has to be come out from somewhere, so there is some steam output. Okay, and that steam output needs to be reused. So what we can do, that we have to condense the steam, we have to utilize that energy. Okay, so we can utilize the steam whatever the coming out, and we have to make it again the superheated steam. We have to heat that steam again to some temperature and again we can make into entry. Okay, the steam we can utilize that steam. So he made some provisions, okay, in the design, so it critically improved the performance of the design. So what he did is greatly improving the amount of work obtained from the unit per fuel consumption. Okay, whatever that unit, obviously that we need some kind of energy to convert water into the steam. For example, we need a coal or we need oil, we have to burn it, we have to create some heat, and that heat will convert the water into the steam. So what he did, that whatever the energy that is wasting Okay, that was wasting. He utilized that energy for again for working, so that reduces the amount that is used. So whatever the fuel consumption was reduced by the James Watt. So that is something interestingly improved. Okay, and you can say this energy steam as a motive force was used in the factory and many machines. Okay, I am giving some of the hint that this machine was used. Okay, in that era, that steam is experimented on all the machines. Wherever there is a need of reciprocating motion or a rotating motion, the steam is utilized and experimented and utilized, and they found it is very useful on that time. Okay, so you can see that this steam is also used for ships, to running ships. Okay, before that we are using sails. So sails was used, and with the help of that, whatever the atmosphere out there, geographical area is there, based on wind, we were sailing over the water. But after that, we have just used steam as a power in the ships, as well as locomotive operated railways. You can see in the early beginnings, the coal were used for creating steam, and that steam was imparted under the piston to create a energy work or rotating motion, or that was the work. Okay, so output was there. So this was the era where steam was used. Okay, in the early 18th century. On that time also there is something called I called chemical manufacturing, or you can say manufacturing of chemical, or you can say production. Okay, so that was also industrialized. Okay, it is not that there was no chemical before that. There was chemicals, but the industries were not there, and on a small scale, few people knew that how to manufacture chemicals, and there is so many experiment was going on to found new chemicals, how to utilize, what is the usefulness of chemicals. So on that time, there is industrialized chemical industry was firstly started in the UK and Europe countries. Okay, and I have just made few things that sulfuric acid was start beginning producing. Okay, by the John Roebuck. Okay, now there is so many people who are working on sulfuric acid. So many people have differently found that sulfuric acid was useful, and they were working on industrialization, how to successfully manufacture sulfuric acid for the demand which market is asking for. So there was something, sulfuric acid was being produced on the big scale. Okay, on that time that big scale was a little bit very low in today's comparison, but there was a big scale. Okay, and then there was something, Nicolas Leblanc. Okay, he convert this common salt into soda ash and sodium carbonate. You might know this is a useful chemical, sodium carbonate and sodium bicarbonate, which is used at the home, okay, for cooking and for bleaching our clothes. So that was firstly he found a process, okay, which is useful for a big scale. Okay, obviously there was a huge demand of soda ash, sodium bicarbonate and sodium carbonate in the market. So they have found that they need a process where they can go for big scale. So that was something which is industrialized. Then coal gas was there, manufactured gas was there, which was used, okay, which you convey it to the metal pipe. So they have found coal gas, and that was produced already, that was invented, but they have found a process where they go for a big manufacturing. Okay, that amount, whatever they were producing, they can produce on a big scale. So that was 1792. Then you can go for 1809. Okay, that primary source of nitrogen flow explosive. Okay, explosive for the and chemical industries. Nitrogen primary source of that was also founded by the Chilean nitrate. Okay. So nitrogen, you can say that right now nitrogen is used at so many places, Okay, but on that time you can say this period was, if you see it as a politically, then on that time there was a war going on between so many nations. Okay, and UK, England is trying to build their colonies at different places. They were ruling over the Europe. Europe was there, and then they have Africa, then India. All the countries they are trying to ruling over the area, and they were extracting some good material which is useful in England. So they are extracting that material. Okay, they are parceling their material. So on that time, explosive was used for the war. Okay, if you see that politically as well as on that time, whatever the current scenario was, according to that, there is a demand was so different. Okay, right now demand is so different, but on that time there is need of explosive war is going on all that, and irrespective of that, there is also need of the market demand, whatever the people were buying. Okay, so that this was also founded. Then now let me get little bit faster. Okay, that coal and tar is and converted into naphthalene. That was also there, the chemical manufacturing industrialized. Okay, then Portland cement was there, concrete and mortar, which are recently used for construction work. Okay, and then rubber was vulcanized, which is used for the tires. Right now we are using for rubber as a tires, but on that time they have no idea that it can be useful as a tire in the tires or rubber belt or anything. Okay, but they have found it and they are using it in a different way. Then petroleum refineries. Okay, one that was in a Peninsula, it was industrialized. Okay, and then Alfred Nobel, on his name we are giving the Nobel Prize. He invented dynamites. Okay, that is explosive, that is useful for the wars. So on that time, it was a time where the war is so many nations was fighting with each other, and war is going on, and it was useful on that time. And right now it is also useful. Okay, it is strengthening the, or you can say making the military asset powerful. Okay, and then cellulose, the first synthetic plastic was introduced by the celluloid. Okay, and then there was you can say acetylene and calcium carbide, which is used produced on a commercial with the use of commercial process. So they were thinking of businesses. So that was the time so many chemical industries was industrialized. Okay, this is a simple, I am not going into detail that how iron produced, but you can say that iron ore from the ground or beneath, we are extracting that iron ore, and this is a furnace where we are in the end of this we will get some kind of a pure iron, not 100% pure, but that we can get the iron as a product. Okay, so we are using coal gas and all that. Okay, that was also produced on a higher level. We have seen it a chemical manufacturing. So this is a furnace in which iron was produced. So that was in a big scale. Okay, obviously you see that steam is used for railways, so we needed that path. Okay, railway path we needed, for that we needed iron. So eventually all the whatever the things which was industrialized and invented were helping each other to grow faster. Okay, then now this is, see, mechanized factory system. You have seen right now you can see this kind of factory system many places, but on that time it was beginning, and it was introduced that mechanized, yeah, with the help of hook, crane and all that machines were used for running a factory. So the work was faster, productivity is increased. Okay, so this was the first industrial realization. Next is second industrial realization. Now in this period, what was invented and used, that is gasoline engines, airplanes, chemical fertilizer. Now whatever the chemical manufacturing in the early first industrial realization, that was lead to the chemical fertilizer. Whatever the ammonia or whatever the other chemicals were industrialized and manufactured on a big scale was introduced to found new chemicals which is useful for household work. So this was there. Okay, and all invention that help us to go faster and do more. So each and every inventions were helping each other in a way so all together can grow faster. Okay, gasoline engines, you know, right now you are using in a your motorbike or you you can call it car. Okay, that is petrol engine. Okay, petrol engine was used, and second was airplanes. Airplanes, you know, Wright brothers, who has firstly did the experiment, and his first flight was like 16 or 30 seconds flight, and no one noticed too much. But after 2-3 experiment, they have gained some recognition that they have found something which can fly. Okay, and you can see that assembly line, that is you have seen the mechanized factory system. Assembly line is something which is used for mass production. Okay, mass production, you can go for mass production in assembly line, like you have, you are using a belt conveyor to move the component. So you just reduces the human effort by the some mechanism. And then 20th century, you can see that this Ford company, you might know the company Ford, which is one of the recognized company in a motor vehicle manufacturing. So that car manufacturing, Henry Ford's company, he used assembly line to firstly in his factory to create manufacture a car. So he used assembly line for manufacturing a car. So he just introduced new thing in his factory, that is assembly line. Then an electric light was almost started to be produced, or you can say production of electric lightning. We know that electric lighting from the, you know, lightning effect from the clouds. So we have idea that something called electricity is there, but that how to produce it, that was a different subject, and that was invented and produced. Okay, so Faraday, then Ampere, so many different scientists were there who given contribution for the electricity. Then radio and telephone, okay, which are run by the electricity. So after electricity, this radio and telephone was happened. So these are few things, like we can see the see what is the assembly line. You can see that it is used for mass production, and there is something like over here there is a belt on which, and there is a few people who are working on that belt. So after a predefined sequence, this the component on the machine will travel at some point, and one more person who is operator, who is working on that machine or sequence, he operates function, and then that whatever the component is move again in according to his sequence. So this is assembly line. You might seen it on Discovery or somewhere, which is nowadays this assembly line is very much useful if you have a product which have a predefined sequence, so many processes, like 100 processes, you have to do it by step by step, then you can must adopt this situation, this system, assembly line in your manufacturing plant or production plant. Then step by step you can manufacture an end product, will you will get somewhere at the end product. Okay, so this is assembly line. So instead of human effort, that this belt and mechanism, belt and conveyor mechanism is useful for the work. Then second is gasoline line, where petrol is used. It is internal combustion engine. So whatever the combustion takes place, we are what we are doing, that is something volatile liquid fuel. This is called petrol. Right now we are calling it petrol, which is burned by the use of electric arc. We are producing some spark, so it will burn, and it will create some heat. That heat is used to run a piston. Okay, so instead of steam, we have used this called gasoline. You can call it petrol. So instead of petrol, steam, we have just gone for the petrol. So that this is something you can say this is very for much useful. Right now you are using, what you have to do, you have to carry that petrol inside. Okay, earlier what was the problem with the steam, that we cannot create so much power with the steam. There are so many disadvantages, and in the system you have to put some condenser which is used to condense the steam. You have to put some pumps so you can continuously pump the steam, and you need nozzle for imparting the steam, and so this is something which reduces all those things, and you can exhaust the gas, whatever the output is there, you can exhaust from gasoline engines. Okay, so exhaust, this is more useful for our work. So we have introduced the gasoline engine. There is some cycle called auto cycle on which it works. Okay, so what we do, we are doing that, we are burning that petrol and we are getting some heat and force, or you can say power. That power is used to move that piston, and that piston will transmit and transform that energy into rotating or a kinetic energy, and that rotation is useful work which is transmitted to the tire, and that vehicle will move. Okay, how it propel, so it will propel like this. So petrol is used. Okay, right now you can see over here. Okay, here there is some called inlet valve and this is outlet valve, and petrol is coming over from here. It is a mixture of petrol and air, so carburetor is working over here. Okay, so petrol is coming over and it was burned with the help of spark plug. You can see in the middle over here, this is a spark plug. So it is sparking and it is burning the petrol. So petrol is burning so flammably, it will create a magnificent power, and that power is giving force to the piston in a downward direction. So that will, with the help of connecting rod, this crank is rotating, and this crank, whatever the, this is over here is a useful work, and this is transmitted to our tire. Okay, with the help of chain sprocket mechanism, you can say, if you see your cycle, in which cycle we are pedaling, and that pedaling is done by the petrol in this case. Okay, this pedaling motion and whatever the we are call it, mechanical energy or human energy, manual energy, what we are giving, this work is done by the petrol, and that energy is transmitted to the drive wheel. Okay, front wheel drive or rear wheel drive, according to that we are moving that energy to the one of the wheel, and it will moving. So it, how it is propel, vehicle is propelling. Okay, so gasoline engine is built in Germany, and after some year, like 10 years, Carl Benz began, okay, first commercial production of motor vehicle. So before that, commercially, you can call it commercially, production was not there. So industry was not there. It was on a small scale, like building a few automobile vehicle which are running, but Carl Benz just industrialized this thing, and that commercial automobile vehicle was in the market in the 1886, and after that so many different companies who gone for the automobile vehicle, and you can right now you can say there is if you see you can name so many companies right now. You can go for Maruti, or you can go for Audi or Mercedes or Ford, okay, Honda. So there is so many companies. Now we are just talking about the beginning of this era, and after that other countries like Japan or Europe who worked on this product, automobile as a product, and they have formed the company and they have industrialized it. So it was a long period of time for industrializing it, but you can say it is like 100 or 50 years of a period on which this thing was industrialized. Okay, so this was there, 1886, Carl Benz, and you can say gasoline engine, it is used in passenger automobile where we are traveling, okay, like Omni and all that. Then small trucks, and for commercial level we were using trucks to transport goods and all that, and for passenger we are using buses. Then in the general aviation aircraft, small aviation aircraft, we were using petrols. Their petrol quality is totally different. And then for small marine unit, you can say small marine unit, and which worked in a sea, we was using petrol in that too for running a ships, okay, small ships, or you can say very small marine units. And then for machine tools and power tools, we were using petrol for running machine tools too. Okay, in the end, what we are running is machine tools. Okay, electricity was not there on that time. Electricity, we are talking about 1900. On that type, electricity was not as a power or a source of energy. It was like in a transition. Okay, it was in a transition that everyone was trying to produce electricity on a small scale, and there was no idea that electricity can be used for machines. Okay, so on that time, petrol engine was used. Early beginning, steam engine were used for machine tools. After that steam, we have come to the something called gasoline. So we have found that gasoline is useful, and we have worked on it. We have experimented with petrol on mostly machines that it can be useful. Okay, for then next is electricity in the early now you can if you see history of electricity, there were so many people, so many scientists who worked on electricity, and it was a long period after which we come to a point where we see electricity as an energy, as a power, as a motive force, and we uses it in a machines, or you can say to run things. So as an energy, we have like 150 years it was taken to reach that point. So it's a long period of time or a long journey. Okay, and every whatever we are right now finding right now, it takes like 50 years or 100 years to useful as a useful energy or useful product. So it takes times to get to that point where it is useful. Okay, so right now let's see about ostrich. Okay, ostrich has discovered magnetic field. So he what he did ostrich is that he just gave that there is something relation between electricity and magnetism. They have idea of magnet, there is something called magnet, there is something called electricity. Now they have to work on this. So they just found that electricity from lightning effect, they have there's something electricity and there is some magnetism, there is some relation, he just found out. Okay, then next is ampere. You know the unit of ampere. Okay, ampere as a unit, but ampere was a scientist, and what he found that there is two parallel current carrying wires is there. One wire is over here, second wire is over here. Okay, and we are running a current over here in between both. So both is giving force to each other. Okay, both are repelling or we are attracting to each other, so there is something called force. So ampere is just given that there is something like force is there, so some exert force which was given, idea was given by the Newton. So there is ampere just told that there is something like force is there, okay, between two wires if they are carrying a current. Then Michael Faraday just invented in 1821, he just found a motor, electric motor. Okay, so that in this case what was happening, that he found that if we are creating some electricity, so electric cell was already introduced and they have idea that electricity can be produced, electric cell was there, and with the what they have did, so if we are there is something called electricity, then with the help of magnet we can get kinetic energy. So as an energy we can give electric, if we giving some kind of electricity, then we can get a rotating or mechanical work, or we can call rotating motion at the end. So that is something that as an input electricity was given and we can get a mechanical work. So Michael Faraday was founded this in 1821, he experimented. In 1831, what he just found that vice versa is also happening. It is possible that if we are using magnet in one kind of sense, that if we are instead of moving this coil, if we move the we can move the magnet, then we can get the electricity. So this is something that Faraday has noticed in after 10 years after finding electric motor. So he found that electricity can be produced in a different with the use of magnet, that is one thing. Okay, in the electric cell that electricity was invented found differently, you can get electricity differently, but this was different with the help of magnet we can get the electricity, that was his idea in 1831. So After that, after so many years, we found that this invention was helpful. Okay, and we commercialize it. Right now, we have every country has their electric power plant. Okay, it can be thermal power plant, or it can be a hydro power plant, or it can be other kind of power plant. But basically, it was there that we have a turbine in which we have to put that magnets. And we can put a coil. Now this turbine is so big, but right now you can understand that there is some wire and we are putting some magnet, and it was like if you give a force, then this magnet will rot give there is a motion between relative motion between this wire and magnet, and you can get a electricity. Okay, now to run a turbine, we are using steam or other mean. That is a different case. We can utilize anything. So magnet was used for electricity generation, and after so many years, every country have a electric power plant. So electricity is generated, and then radio and this telephone was invented. Now this was useful in a factory for mostly in early time. This telephone was used by the important persons only and for factory work, so you can communicate easily. Okay, and radio was used for transmitting the frequencies to another place, so you can communicate, you can give the messages. So in the early time it was there. Okay, in the 19th century we have radio and telephone, which was like on a very low scale. A few people have that and they were using it. And after that, third industrial revolution. I am not going to talk in detail about digital revolution. Early before that, we are working on an analog system now, and after that, we have come to the digital technology. So many things was founded. Okay, and this was like a very revolutionary, you can say, semiconductor electronic circuits. After electric, we come up to electronic systems. And electronic system have something which is something very interesting, that we can compact the machines. Okay, instead of machines, gigantic machines, we can compress this machine into a small circuit. So that semiconductor, then mainframe computing, personal computing, and internet. It was something that is after 1850, the third revolution. After third revolution, we get this technology in the market. And it takes like 7 to 8 years, and now every place is like having this thing in common use. Okay, so it was in a common use. Right now we are using it. If you see a mobile phone which is having a semiconductor diode and chip and all that. Okay, so if you see, like you can see over here, this is a chip on which there is diode and transistor and all this. Okay, so this chip, it is a before that there is a need of wire and instrument, so it was so big. And after use of semiconductors and transistors and diodes and all that, just we come to point where we can reduce the size of machine just by a chip or this kind of panel. Okay, and we have then found a computer. Okay, and if you see history of computer, then you can go for like 900, around 900 there was few inventions there which are connected to the computers. Okay, and then like calculator and all that was there, and then we come to point like 1950, we have computer. That computer was so big on that time. That computer was so big, and it will have very low calculation capability. So capability is very low. And after like 50 years, we come to a point where we just reduce the size of the computer and just increase the capability of the computer. So it takes time, but right now we have very advanced technology in the computer. We have laptop, we have notebooks. So after a time, there is a phase which takes times to make things a better thing. Okay, then industrial. Right now we have seen this industrial robots were used for multi operations. Robots were used for manufacturing and production, and it is something that reduces the human error It increases the quality, it reduces the human error, so it is something useful. Right now you have seen this foundry work, in foundry work industrial robots are here. Okay, and those chips and computer, we can connect it with computer, we can use these chips to as a useful unit to work this industrial robot. And industrial robot have something very interesting usefulness, that if some place is there which is very difficult to go for a human, then we can't risk the life of human and we can go for the robots. So that is usefulness, like space exploration. In space exploration we can utilize robot. Okay, and if we are going for a marine exploration, if we want to go to the bottom of the sea, then we can use robot as a useful product. Okay, so and then like we can call it foundry work or some kind of places which is not good for the human or dangerous to the human, then we can go for a robot. So robot was there. Right now we are not using robot. If we see India, then there is something which is we are overpopulated and we don't need machines to work. We are not mainly relying on machines. Okay, we have enough human force to complete the work. So we are less of this robot and things. Okay, still we are trying to work with the global competence. We are trying to work working on those how to implement those technology in our current day-to-day work. Okay, so every company is trying to utilize those technology, they are trying to adjust with these technologies, but we are not fully ready for right now. We are not using all these technologies. Okay, we are using, but we are at very least. Okay, and now right now we are at the fourth industrial revolution. Right now we are working on a fourth industrial revolution, and so many things are there. Okay, you have seen robots, and right now robot is useful thing in many things. Okay, not in a Indian industry robot is not useful. Right now we are not using too much robots because we don't have that need. Okay, second is artificial intelligence. Just give intelligence to the machines, so it will like it is a brain to the machines, and it will act according to his intelligence. So we don't have to you can call it give instruction to the machines. Machine will automatically work, it will have sensors and so many things, and it will work automatically. We just have to just watch over the machines, that's it. Okay, so human work is less in this case. Okay, and we are working on this technology. Every company, many organizations are working on artificial intelligence. Okay, and then internet of things, and then 3D printing, genetic engineering, quantum computing. These are few things right now in a beginning, you can call it. It is like beginning from 2010. There is so many things, experiment and inventions was going on, and technology is emerging right now. Okay, then electric vehicle is there. Every company right now we are seeing that electricity can be useful for, instead of petrol we can go for electricity to run a vehicle. Obviously that petrol, we know that there is a scarcity of petrol, and petrol is like something which is costing much, and electricity, if we are going for electricity, it will be more optimum solution for our vehicle. So we will reduce the cost of traveling. That is something on which the government is also working, as well as the other countries, nations was also working. Like if you see in Japan electric vehicles are 10-20 years ago they were working on the electric vehicle, and they have electric vehicles. Okay, so they have reached that technology, and we are just we are behind that time. We are just in the beginning where we want to adopt the electric vehicles. Okay, so for us this is a opportunity to work on this electric vehicle. Then robotics is there. You have seen this quadcopter, it is called quadcopter. Okay, there is four wings is there, four you can say fan is there. So quadcopter, which is used for right now, we are using it for like electric military can be used. It is useful to military as well as many thing who want to watch over a period, or we are using for a shooting and all that. Okay, but it having a different application which is more useful than electric vehicle. We will going to charge the vehicle instead of fueling it with petrol. We can go for the electricity. Okay, so this is more optimum solution. Right now we can see electricity is more optimum, but there is something we cannot implement some limitation, like in one charge how many kilometers we can run. So many organizations is working on this. Okay, and they want to give something called a useful product. So it is emerging. The next is, you can say 3D printing is there in the market. For manufacturing we are using printing process. Okay, obviously in 3D printing there is very interesting that if you want to something produce something, then we have to produce it layer up. So printing is used as a manufacturing. We can create, now it is having very good interesting application that human organs like heart and kidney. So patients who have a problem with heart and kidney, we can manufacture it with the use of 3D printing. So okay, so this is something useful application of this, and we are trying to use it for manufacturing a component of many machines and automobiles too. 3D printing can be useful for manufacturing. Okay, so it is not on a big scale right now. We are trying to commercialize this 3D printing. Okay, so it is in an emerging process. Then artificial intelligence, if I give a some simple example, if you have a car, okay, and it is having an artificial intelligence, then all you have to do is that on a map you have to just indicate first point and last point, and it will drive automatically to the last point. You don't have to do anything. It will automatically sense, it will have sensors, so it will sense the traffic, the people around, there is obstruction, whatever there is, it will sense and it will react automatically based on artificial intelligence, and it will reach the point. Okay, so there is so many things. There is facial recognition, then automatic task, automatically it will work, it will automatically calculate. Okay, so whatever the symbol is there on the road, it will see it and it will interpret it, that it what it want to say, that you have to just drive it with 30 kilometer power, then it will automatically reduce the speed to the 30 kilometer per hour. So that is artificial intelligence. You can see that if you see in home, we are using switches to run a fan. Instead of that, you can connect it with the internet, and you can connect the fan with internet, and you will connect the mobile with internet, and you can run the fan with the use of mobile phone. So that is something called Internet of Things. Okay, artificial intelligence and internet things both will connected to each other and will work on it. Okay, right now we are working on this, that we can run an aeroplane with the help of internet. Okay, this is something called that reduces the human effort. Okay, human will see it and just watch over the application, and this thing will run automatically with the help of artificial intelligence and the internet. Okay, like we can connect the internet with cycles, okay, with the automobile vehicle, with the telephone, with the TV. Okay, we can see that we can control the TV with the help of mobile or internet. But there will be time that internet can be used, like you are sitting in your office on the laptop, and you can run your home from there. You can use their phone from the home, or you can use you can switch on or switch off the TV from home, or like that. Okay, you can so it is like Internet of Things, that internet will run everything. You can connect internet with everything, and you can use the internet as a controller. So this is something on which right now this is a area of research where everyone is working, and it will be implemented real soon. Like many countries has started, in India it will take time, many years to accommodate, or like we will not adopt it. That depends on future. I don't know government is what government is thinking, but on the government it is, but there is so many technologies which is emerging and on which government is also working. So this is the thing. Okay, right now if you can see that solar energy is useful energy, and government is focusing on solar energy and forcing people to adopt the solar energy. So this is depends on government and whatever the geography and political scenario, as well as the what is the companies, the different organizations and companies thinking, and they want to adopt it or not. So it is there. Okay, so this is the fourth industrial revolution on which we are right now, and you can see that many things is directly or indirectly connected with the industrial revolution, and it is also impact the society and people, because if they are companies is working and they are providing in the market, then people will buy it and they will adapt to it. So it is connected, but there is it is one perspective. So I have just given an idea that what is industrial revolution and how time went, timeline went, and different inventions was happened, and those industrial revolution reaches a point where we are at the fourth industrial revolution. What can be the future? Okay, we can say flying car in future maybe. Okay, and many companies working on it, and there is in a flying car also, but it is not that effective. It has a limitation, so companies working on that. Okay, so this is our industrial revolution, and I hope I be able to explain it, that how things went and how things going to happen, and it will be useful to the society. So thank you.